Wrote a song for your love and it go like this. Till we gone with the wind and we blow like fish.
Guys, what is up? Welcome to another episode of Maximilian Must Know. Today I'm responding to a tag that the gentleman, wonderful gentleman from the channel Waft from Aloft, I'm sorry, tagged me in, and it's One Fragrance to Rule Them All. And this was a channel I was sort of acquainted with before I got the tag. And then when I was tagged, a few people let me know, and I really dug in deep to more of the videos from these two guys. And what a wonderful channel it is. Of course, I'll link to it in the description. These guys are just so knowledgeable, and the amount of passion and knowledge that they put into their channel, it's really stunning to me. It's something to behold. They recently did a video on their top 10 favorite oud fragrances, and of course I'm learning as I'm watching it. So thank you for tagging me. I will give a tag at the end. And this has been a video that a few different people have done. It's recently your one fragrance to rule them all. Different people have done it different ways. They've done a couple. I've frequently talked about Fahrenheit being my favorite designer fragrance. I was tagged in a video to do my induction into the Fragrance Hall of Fame, and I picked Jubilation 25. So I wanted to go with something that I really hadn't just spoken about my affection for before. I have spoken about my affection for this one before in a review and in other videos, but I don't think I've done like one video on, you know, my dedication or soul dedication to this fragrance. And the fragrance I'm obviously picking, it's not hard to see, is Zing by L'Artisan Parfumer. This is my favorite niche fragrance. This is a 1999 fragrance release, so it's, you know, 20 years old at this point. It was done by the great Olivia Giacobetti. She's just an amazing perfumer. She's done Fisocos for Diptyque, which is, I think, one of the best fig fragrances ever created. Fuda Absinthe for this brand. En Passant for Frederick Malle, which is a beautiful lilac fragrance with a baked bread note. Ideal for Lubon, gorgeous rum amber fragrance. Elixir for Penhaligon. So her resume is very official. And she did this one for Penhaligon's, and it was sort of her homage to the circus. And the notes on it are leather, tonka bean, ginger, woods, musk, caramel, saffron, cotton candy, toffee, and candied apple. You can get this bottle online at this 100 ml size for about 60, 80 bucks, depending on whether you get that new L'Artisan bottle or the old school one. I prefer the old school bottle with that woman riding a tiger, I guess it is, and that playfulness. And you can see I've gone through a good deal of this. So there's two reasons why I love this one, and I'll explain them both briefly, and then I'll tag, you know, the next person first. I think this is just an amazing fragrance. I really love the dichotomy here between a animalic musky leather. I get like a real animalic musk in this one, and I get a real rough leather. So it's like a horse saddle with a little bit of like a stable, like a circus stable accord. So you have that animalic piece to this one, but then you also have this gourmand circus piece to this one. So I get the cotton candy, I get the toffee, and I get the candied apple. So it really does sort of smell like being at a circus, and I think it works really well. I think it's a sexy, really sexual gourmand fragrance that I've just never smelled anything like. And to this day, when people sort of say like, oh, you know, what can you compare it to Zing? Not much. Like, I don't think like this one, people haven't replicated this one. Designers haven't sort of been like, we'll make our version of this. The clone houses have stayed away. This is really its own thing. And it's really unique and it's really good. Second part of why I am picking this one is because this, as someone who was interested in one day becoming a perfumer, this sort of changed my notion of, oh, you know, fragrance has to just make you smell good, or has to smell of the aquatic or spicy or gourmand, you know what I'm saying, or citrus-like, aromatic. You can make a fragrance smell like a place. This is a circus, obviously, but like, okay, and it really got my mind spinning. You can make it smell like a time, you know, a period of time. You could make it smell like a memory. And to say, like, we're going to do a fragrance of the circus. And I know this isn't the, certainly not the first fragrance that ever took that sort of approach. Let's not make something that just is a jumble of notes that smells good. Let's actually recreate the aroma of a place. But for me, it was one of the first that that I discovered. And I talk about that with Sartorial and some other ones, right? But this really is the one that blew my mind. And I just really enjoy this one. I love the playfulness of it. I love the art of the woman on the tiger. I love the idea behind it. I think it smells really good. I think when I wear this, I just feel special, you know? Like, to be honest with you, I feel like no one else is wearing this. And I do also feel like sometimes, you know, there's fragrances you like for certain reasons and you know they're not super wearable, but you still enjoy them. I feel like this is really wearable. I just feel like it's an animalic gourmand. And I feel like one, two sprays in the right situation, it's a really awesome, nice fragrance to wear. It's affordable, it's creative, it inspired me. And so those are the reasons why, you know, this is my one to rule them all. Look, if I was going to do this, it would be Fahrenheit. But I feel like I've just talked so much about Fahrenheit and why I love Fahrenheit. And I really just wanted to sort of give that, you know, expression to this one, because this is my favorite niche fragrance of all time. So that's my one to rule them all. I want to thank the gentleman from Lost in the Loft. I'm going to link to their amazing channel, and I'm going to tag Joe Anthony. He has a channel called Unaverage Joe. He sort of goes back and forth. He makes videos, and he had to go away for a while. Then he comes back, but he has a really good perspective. And I'd love to hear his one to rule them all. I wanted to sort of give you guys one a tag that, you know, you might not know. I'm sure a lot of people know Joe. He's got about 1,000 subscribers. But I'd like to hear his one to rule them all. And I'm going to tag him, and I'm going to link to him in the description. And you should definitely check his videos out. But again, I want to thank these two total gentlemen and amazing, fragrance encyclopedias. For my tag, and I want to hear, you know, definitely leave a comment. Let me know, maybe these guys watching the loft, they'll check out your comments, and let us all know your one to rule them all. And I'll see you guys again real soon with another video. Tagging Watson the Loft in the description, tagging Joe, and please check out. See you guys soon with the next video.